Welcome, everyone. This is Alex Tabarrok. Today, we're going to be taking a look at the Rule of 70. The Rule of 70 is a simple rule of thumb, which says that if a process is growing at a rate of X percent per period, then the doubling time is approximately 70 divided by X periods. So, for example, U.S. GDP per capita grows at a rate of about 2% per period. A little bit more than that, but we'll make our numbers nice. So if the growth rate of U.S. GDP per capita is 2% per period, then the doubling time for GDP per capita is 70 over 2, or approximately 35 years. So if you're 35 years old today and you have a child, then by the time your child is 35, his or her standard of living will be about double yours, again, holding all else the same. Now let's compare with China. In China, GDP per capita has been growing for about the past 30 years at a rate of between 7 and 10% per year. Absolutely astounding. So in China, GDP per capita is doubling approximately every 7 years. So this means that in the time it takes GDP per capita to double in the United States, in China, GDP per capita will have gone up by 2 to the 5th, or by 32 times. Now, even today, China is much poorer than the United States. So what this tells you is that in the past, China was really, really poor. So poor that they could grow at this enormous rate and still be poorer than the United States today. China probably has a few more doublings in its future, though you can also guess by these kind of numbers that China's probably going to slow down. Its growth rate is going to slow down. We'll talk more about that when we come to talk about the solo model. Let's use the same technique to look at world population growth rates. Let's go to Google and pull in some data on world growth rates. Okay, here from Google is the world's population growth rate. And what we see is that in the late 1960s and early 1970s, the world population was growing at a rate of about 2% per year. In other words, as we just saw, the total world population was doubling every 35 years. Today, however, we're much closer to 1% per year. And in fact, we're even heading downwards, might even go down to 0% per year, would not be inconceivable. At a rate of growth of 1% per year, the total world population doubles every 70 years. This is one reason why I'm not worried about world population growth rates. We can handle a doubling over the next 70 years. That's really not such a big problem. And indeed, if world population growth rates continue to decline and probably even stabilize, it won't be any problem at all. It may even be an issue that we want a larger growth rate. Okay, let's use our rule of 70 for one more neat little trick. Between 1970 and 2008, per capita medical spending in the United States grew at a rate of about 4% per year. Now remember, U.S. GDP per capita is growing at a rate of 2% per year. So medical spending is growing at twice the rate as per capita GDP. In other words, medical spending is growing faster than GDP by 2% per year. This means that as a share of U.S. GDP, medical spending will double in approximately 35 years, 70 over 2. Now, today, medical spending as a share of GDP is about 16%. If it continues to grow 2% faster than does U.S. GDP per capita, then in 35 years, it'll be 32%, or approximately a third of the economy will, a third of the economy spending will be on healthcare spending, on medical spending. Now it's clear that even if the economy as a whole could handle a rate on medical spending of a third, that there's many people in the U.S. economy could not handle that rate, many people below median income, that would be a real problem. So something is going to break. Either it's going to be the budget, or it's going to be, hopefully, we'll be able to slow down the growth rate of medical spending. Either way, the rule of 70 gives us a quick and dirty rule of thumb for calculating doubling times and other kind of interesting percentages. Thanks very much.